guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. This is a continuation of the bound services concept that I have been discussing in the previous video. In the previous video, I have covered how to implement the onBind method which returns a iBinder interface. That is first half of the implementation about how to prepare the service to connect to the front end or any other component so that it is ready to receive any connection from the component. In this particular video, I will show you how to implement a service connection API in the component which wants to connect to the service. In this case, it is an activity. So without much further ado, let's get into a demo. So you are already familiar with this particular UI. Start of the service will start the service and stop will stop the service. And I have already created three buttons, bind service, unbind service, and get random number. When I click on the get random number, whatever the random number that is getting generated in the service in the background will get updated in the text view here. Let us wire up the code here. I have created an instance of my service and I have used a boolean variable isBooleanBound which I will be using to check whether the service is bound or unbound. Then I have a service connection instance. This service connection instance need to be initialized. That happens whenever I hit on the bind service button. I have bind service method, unbind service, and set random number. Bind service method is the method that gets executed whenever I click on the bind service button. In this, I will check if the service connection is null, then I will initialize it. Service connection is equal to new service connection. You can see that I have to override two methods. The two methods are onServiceConnected and onServiceDisconnected. And whenever onService is disconnected, boolean variable isServiceBound, I will make it false. And in this case, I will make isServiceBound true. But this is not sufficient. I need to initialize service instance that I have created, that is my service. That can be got from the iBinder. So in the my service, I have created my service binder. I can write my service binder is equal to and typecast the iBinder that I am getting in the callback method here into my service binder. Then I can initialize my service using my service binder dot get service. This will get me the service instance and I will initialize it. So we are done with the implementation of on service connected, and in on service disconnected I am making is service bound false. Next, after this I need to bind to the service. For that I have another method called as bind service, and you need to pass intent service connection and a constant flag. I will use the existing service intent that I have, service intent, and then we have just initialized the service connection. Then the third component is constant context dot bind auto create. You can see that I have various other constants here, but this is the typically default that we usually use, bind auto create. What this basically does is it will create the service if it is not yet created when the service tries to bind. In the unbind service method, I am checking if it is bound, and if it is bound, then only I will unbind it and I will make the isServiceBound boolean variable as false. The final method is set random number. I will check if the service is bound, then only I will set the random number to the text view. Otherwise, I will set the message service is not bound. We are done with the implementation. Let us run the code. So the app has started and I will click on the start service, and you can see that the random numbers are getting generated. And if I click on the get random number now, I will get a message saying that service is not bound. Then if I stop service, the service will get destroyed. I will once again start the service and I will bind service. You can see that onBind method got executed, and now if I hit the get random number, you can see that I am getting the random number. If I click another time, I will get the another new random number. Now if I hit on the unbind service, you can see that onUnbind method got executed. Now if I hit the get random number, you can see that the service not bound. What I will now do is I will stop the service and I will hit the bind service. You can see that the onBind method got executed. And if I now hit the get random number, I will get 0 as the output. What I am trying to basically say is it is perfectly legitimate to bind to a service which is not under execution. Now what I will do is, I will start the service. The service is still bound, and now if I hit the get random number, I will get the random number, and I will try to stop service. You can see that the service is not stopping because the service is bound. A bound service cannot be stopped. Until and unless all the components which are connected to the service are unbound, then only the service can be destroyed. If I click on the unbind service, it will be automatically stopped because then there will not be any component which would be connected to that particular service. So let me hit on the unbind service, and you can see that the service destroyed method is getting executed. And now if I hit the get random number, I will get service not bound. Let me restart service and let me hit bind service, and I will hit bind service again. But you can see that onBind is not getting executed again and again. OnBind method gets executed only once, because once the iBinder is returned from the onBind, it will not execute onBind again and again. And after hitting the unbind, you will not see unbind getting executed again and again, no matter how many number of times I try to unbind service. Let us try to put everything in a nutshell. Any component can bind to both started on unstarted service, and any number of components can bind to a service. A bound service usually cannot be destroyed. It depends upon what constant that you pass when you are binding to a service. There is always an exception. And also, a bound service is liable to get destroyed in case of resource crunch. If stop service has been called while the service was bound, it will be stopped automatically when all the components from the service are unbound. Components which can bind to a service are activity, service, and content provider. You cannot use a broadcast receiver to connect to a service. So that brings us to the end of this particular video, and if you are interested in something, please comment in the below section. Don't forget to share, subscribe, and like. Bye, take care.